John McAvick, Texas is 27-3-1 when they're leading at the half. So Jack, he's got to be optimistic right now.
Coach, at halftime, you're such a master of motivational speeches. What did you tell the crew?
Well, 30 minutes for the championship. We've played hard to get to this spot, but it's not over. I thought we played a terrific first half. Nebraska did, too. We knew they'd fight back.
What about the performance of your offense and James Brown? It looked like you had to maybe calm him down just a little bit in the beginning.
Well, a little bit, but James plays well for us. He's made a lot of big plays. Our offense is doing well. I really think our defense is playing well also, though.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. You know, Coach, one of the other things we should remember about McAvick, like Landry, they always keep plays in their saddlebag for the second half.
Last week against A&M, he didn't start running the counter play, which has been so effective in the first half, until the second half and ate him alive. So he saved stuff.
Speaking of Nebraska, was it Mike Tyson who once said, everybody's got a game plan until you're hit in the mouth? I think it was. I heard Mike.
You would know better than me.
Well, that means Nebraska here has been hit in the mouth, ladies and gentlemen. And let's see how they react.
I think they would be wise, Brent, to try to maintain ball control. Because Texas defense, Texas offense, rather, has the defense shaken just a little bit. You know, they moved the ball awfully well. 265 yards there in that first half. Good balance for running and passing.
Stockton kicking it off as James Brown's talking upstairs. Now that's calm right there, folks. That's cool. We carry out a conversation and we can still get loose.
He came by me in the practice field the other day and I said, James, how's it going? He says, all I'm thinking about is winning.
Cheetah Bennett back deep as we start the second half of the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. A bouncer landing at the 4-yard line. And the 20, Curtis Priest. Good return. Excellent field position out at the 36-yard line. Now, we take a look at the numbers here from the first half.
Well, the big edge is the passing yards for Texas right here. That's a real plus. The other thing, they haven't been penalized. Nebraska has the time of possession edge, and I would suggest they keep trying to do that. Points off turnover, Nebraska 7, Texas 3. Pretty even football game. A little more balance in the run-pass ratio on the Texas side.
A field goal difference right now with the horns ahead. Option look. Long's going to make the toss now to Evans.
Did you see that?
Well, I was kind of...
Oh, my God.
I thought an animal was in pursuit of me, ladies and gentlemen. I thought you were about to bite me in the neck.
Vedrill, the outside wide receiver that came down and cracked, and I think the outside linebacker thought an animal hit him. Believe me, that he decked him. You know, they have many different grades for receivers blocking, but you can't do it any better than that.
Coach, who gets the deer, me or the dog?
You do. Holy mackerel, was that it? Bottom of your screen, here, number 25. Pow! Hello.
Second down and two. Now Frost, hello. Down at the 39-yard line. How do you do? Big number 95. Ray Mosher from Kearney, Texas, a sophomore, makes the play.
Yeah, a sophomore, one of those young guys, a sophomore defensive end, a true freshman defensive tackle, a junior defensive tackle, and a true freshman defensive end. So they're very young inside. They have a lot to look forward to next year. Penetration has hurt the option each time. They've got to keep those inside gaps sealed.
Third and eight. Federal and Holbein are off to Frost's right. Angelo Evans, the freshman from Wichita, Kansas, the I-back. Good time. Evans, right flat, beats the linebacker. First down, Nebraska. Coming over to make that stop was Tyson King, and Evans put a move on him.
Taking a look at Nebraska's first half possession. Bringing out initially, and then they get the nice 12-play touchdown. Beautiful drive. Three plays and fumble, turn it over, in which Texas gets the field goal. 7-play field goal, 11-play touchdown. They really gain momentum in that second quarter. Now it's important that they carry it over here.
On first down, Evans bounces left, and again he is cut off. That play was very well defended that time, and that was Casey Hampton, the freshman, number 64, making another good play. You can see our leaders here in the first half. Frost did not throw an interception, but he did have a bad pitch on one play. Evans, 77 yards, two touchdowns for the Huskers, and on defense, Stokes, the safety, four tackles and an interception in the end zone that looms larger and larger as this day unfolds. Second down and 11.
Option.
Frost, option look. Here it is. Evans cut off. Makes his way to the 48. That's about the original line of scrimmage, coach.
Still not getting that pitch out there cleanly, Brent. That was thrown back on his left hip, and that prevented him from sprinting to the sideline and maybe getting outside into the perimeter.
I think it has seemed sometimes in watching Scott that he pitches it a little too quickly.
I think so, too. He did that definitely one time in the second quarter, and that time maybe he's got to take it right on. But credit the defense. See, they're not putting pressure right in his face. They're using what they call a sweat technique, just making guess where you're going to come after.
All right, here's a passing situation. Third and 10 for Frost. They set the screen. Evans and nothing doing this time. Tyson King, who was beat earlier, comes up and makes the big hit here.
Well, he read it all the way. A lot of experience at this linebacker position. Number 50, Tyson King. He'll flash from the right side of your screen here. He reads it. This is his 38th start as a linebacker at Texas. He gets blocked initially. He reads it, comes inside out, does a real nice job of wrapping him up and getting him down. Big tackle. Very, very important defensive series for Texas to come in there and shut him out right now and try to, you know, maintain that control.
They were in on Jesse Cush when he punted in the first half. Horns put some heat on him. And they'll come in again. There, Jesse's real good under pressure. There's the fair catch and out of bounds at the 18, Mike Adams. So when we come back, Texas will have the ball and a 2017 lead. Texas first possession of the second half down in the end zone that is alive with a sea of red. Making it hard for any audible, but this play would have been called over the sideline as the horns came out. Leading it 20-17 here in the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. Counter back with number 3, Sean Mitchell.
See, now again, they're bringing that backside linebacker to chase the counter from behind, and Minner has the kind of speed to go ahead and do that. They're going to have to do something in a key and come back out there and make them worry about that type of play.
Priest Holmes, who was a standout here in the first half, checks into the game. He rushed for 97 yards, had a long run of 61, and he scored two touchdowns for Coach McAdam. He's back in that tailback spot. Williams offset on the right wing. Play fake. Brown steps away from pressure, comes middle, complete. Adams runs free. 45, midfield. 45, 40, and out of bounds at the 35-yard line.
Now they bought the rush, and the rush got wide upfield. But Adams stepped up, Brown rather stepped up inside that pocket, maintained his poise. There was no defensive tackle pressure, and found the crossing pattern. He was outside, he'll cross to the inside. See, they turn him loose back in there, must be playing an INO, an inside and outside coverage on him, and there was no inside coverage. Loose zone, he picks it up and puts it down.
We saw that signal from McAvitt. That's the signal for a two tight end formation. So Fitzgerald and Lewis dash onto the field, not hesitating after the 47-yard gain. Quick count, here's Williams, sprints over to the left, looks for a seam, and he will be stopped at the 30-yard line, picked up a couple of yards on the play before he would stop Eric Stokes.
You see what McAvick did then, you said it, quick count, he went up there, two tight ends lined up, bang. He had the defense running, reeling a little bit, he comes out, he doesn't give him time to take a deep breath. Nobody does it much better than this guy.
He's one of the best play callers I've been around.
And game planners. Hey, not so much what you call, it's how you plan it.
Second down and 7. Ball's at the 30-yard line. With the Huskers reeling with this outstanding defensive unit. Now Fitzgerald flexes to an H-back on that left side. Timeout. Brown saw something he didn't see, and the clock was coming down on him. And he realized rather than take a 5-yard penalty, he'd use up one of his 3 TOs. So a reminder, what's coming up on Monday night, it'll be
the president and general manager of the Chiefs came down here before game and said hello, and I asked him about the Raider team, and he said they've improved a lot. He says, I hope we're back on track and playing. It's going to be a tough football game, and a good one. That series has been a good one over a long period of time.
Jackaroo, what's up down there with Texas?
Well, Brent, you alluded to the fact that Ricky Williams is a two-sport player. He took up baseball, he says, because he didn't like track. He didn't like the fact that you had to practice by yourself. Highly sought after out of high school as a baseball player, but when he talked to the team and said, I want to play football, most of them walked away from him. But the Philadelphia Phillies signed him with a $50,000 signing bonus, and he played in the Phillies minor league organization. Now, what did he do with the $50,000 signing bonus? He gave it to his sister so she could pay her college tuition.
Yeah, wonderful gesture, the young man's part. Second down and 7, the ball up the Nebraska 30-yard line. The horns driving, and they lead it by 3. And Brown back, waiting, going deep right side. Incomplete, had a man. Oh, McGarity had broken free, and if it was just a couple of yards shorter, it was 6 more for the horns.
That's the same concept pattern-wise that they did not see break wide open in the first quarter. That's the slot receiver, the inside receiver of Duke, going to the sideline and then up the sideline where the wide receiver goes downfield. Many times people make mistakes in that. A little bit of a tough throw.
McAvick checking with his assistants upstairs, sequencing his plays. Always knows what's ahead, 3rd and 7, depending on the down and distance, what he wants to do. Ball is at the 30-yard line. Brown will be in a shotgun. There's a handoff. Now Williams is eaten up. That was, I believe, Jason Peter, number 55, who came across, read the play, and got a hand on number 11 before it could develop.
Well, that's the style of defense they like to play. Pressure, disrupt you, slow your hitting play. Not a bad call, but if you're going to run that play, you don't mind penetration outside your tackles, but you can't allow any inside over your guards, and that's what happened. Jason Peter did a good job.
So he's hit from 49 and 30 yards. Schultes on, put it down on this 47-yard attempt.
7 for 10 from this distance this year.
Nice to have a kicker like that. It was a luxury and a 6-point lead as the result of Dawson's 3rd field goal of the first ever Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. Timeout. The Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship on ABC, brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road, and the new Coors Light wide-mouth can. Tap the Rockies with a smoother pour. Brent Musburger with Dick Vermeil and Jackaroo. Texas, a 3-touchdown underdog with a 6-point lead here in the third quarter on Nebraska, 23-17. And Dawson will kick this one off. So the experiment with the other kicker is over. And they have made the switch. A short, high, Cheatham fielding it at the 13-yard line. 25, and Cheatham will go down at the 28-yard line. You know, it's interesting, Dick, looking at that scoreboard, 23 points put up there by Texas. That's the most points scored against this Nebraska defense this season. And Oklahoma had the previous high of 21, but they were buried it earlier in that game, 73-21. And last year, the most points scored against this Nebraska defense, 24 by Florida. And so I remember that final was 62-24 down in the desert. So this is a heck of a job being done by Texas. And now Frost and the Cornhuskers come back out. All right, got real estate. Frost down at the 35-yard line. And there is Bryant Westbrook at the corner making a sure stop. And there's an injured Longhorn down at the 28-yard line. We've got an injured player. You know, this is a lovely new facility. First time we've had an opportunity, Dick, to visit it. And it was a kind of a floating feeling down there when you walked on the field. And the fellow who put it up, this whole complex, this convention center, interestingly enough, covers 32 acres. And it's going to mean so much to the city of St. Louis in bringing conventions in here. Forget about just the football games. But they were telling me that they pump air
down into there. And so the whole idea of the AstroTurf surfaces, I think Monsanto made this rug, it's one piece. There are no zippers. And I was struck by that because we finally got a player down who's injured, because you and I have been on artificial rugs where the surface is so hard for everybody to go down on. This one is seems to be very, very comfortable.
It did. It really did, Brent. You know, and, of course, it's new. Of course, it doesn't go through freezing cold weather and harden the mat underneath. There's, you know, so it's got a lot of advantages.
For fans who come here, we will tell you that we rate the hot dogs number one.
Boy, it was good. Oof.
That is Mosier, who is shaken up, being tended to. Let's hope that he's going to be okay. And
that's Spanky Stevens and trainer staff.
And tomorrow, the regional activity on the Payne Weber College basketball. Michigan Duke will be the lead game, and also Maryland against California. So see how that unfolds at 1:30 Eastern time here on the network.
Young redshirt sophomore, they're going to miss him because he is their leading quarterback pressure guy coming in there. And they have to go now back, if they come right with normal rotation, a red true freshman playing in behind him, Cedric Woodward, who hasn't played a lot because he's been banged up. He's just coming off the injured list. Let's see who they put in out there. They could come with another true freshman in Will Goodlow from Spring Valley, California. There he is.
So Goodlow gets down in his stance. Big moment for him here. Evans dives toward that first down marker. Dusty Renfro making the stop. Dusty, it'll be close.
Dusty has made another. You know, he has a real good feel of when to move along and then go ahead and attack across the line of scrimmage through a gap that he finds.
Down. A 6-point lead for the Longhorns. Texas capturing Southern Division in the Big 12. They did it the hard way. 4-game winning streak at the end of the season. Every game, an elimination game down the stretch for the Horns. Federal, this is Frost looking for his wide receiver. And he hit him at the 49-yard line. Again, close to another first down as Bedrill had moved in motion, and he makes the catch.
See, that's the same movement that Bedrill had used to get that vicious outside-in crack block. This time they fake the crack block, cross him underneath the formation, underneath the secondary, and just saw a play-action pass. Good design, good change-up.
Tyson King takes the defensive signal, passes on. Let's watch this again.
See, now last time he cracked the outside linebacker. This time he goes beyond the linebacker, finds a little seam in there, settles down, gets the completion.
Now the ball close to midfield. Evans looking left. 9-yard run.
I'll tell you, Chris Dishman, what an alert football player. We talked about him in the first half. This time, he's going to pull right here, and he'll turn back and seal. He reads something different. He gets pulled. Now watch him turn and seal. Now watch him turn back. Bang, right there. That gave him the little crack to get up inside there, and he doesn't miss many holes when he sees that daylight.
19 carries, 95 yards. D'Angelo Evans, second down and one. The ball at the Longhorn 41-yard line. Cross pulls back out. Going to swing it out wide. Down to Evans. Evans twists. First down, Nebraska.
They wanted to go deep. Secondary looking for the deep pass on that down. They couldn't throw it. Just lays it off out there.
Jonathan Hickerson wrapped him up after the completion, but it was good for a Nebraska first down inside the Horns 40-yard line. Nebraska down 6, 23-17. 6:27 remaining in the third. The fullback, Schuster, powering to the 34-yard line.
Nice block by Aaron Taylor on Casey Hampton that time. Casey Hampton was playing the nose technique right on, and he just ran, the running back just ran off the left side of your screen. You'll see Taylor, 67, take him the way he wanted to go, and he just bangs up in there.
They want to keep that fullback pounded up inside because that helps the option game that comes off that in a later call.
Second down and five. Ball at the Horns 34. Option crossed on a cutback. He's to the 29-yard line, close to another first down.
What they did that time, Brent, on the option is they pulled the guard and blocked the man that would normally make the quarterback pitch. Therefore, nobody in his face. Therefore, he becomes the runner more consistently. Sometimes you can read that in the move and still making pitch. That time he just took it up inside for a nice game.
Third and one. Fedro brings the play in. Coach Osborne sideline.
Scott Ross doing a nice job.
First down, steps for 2 yards, and it'll be spotted around the 28-yard line.
Great
change move.
Great contact that time by linebacker and Brian Schuster, fullback. Boy, they ran into each other. It was a heck of a collision. Schuster right there. I think he's feeling his shoulder a little bit after that lead block. Concentrate right here, and then the linebacker Phil, awfully good contact made. Here it comes. Pow! See, just enough to get the first down.
First and 10 for Frost, runs the option. They keep it on a cutback. There was an alley there, and he makes his way to the 23 before Aaron Humphrey can bring him down. Good first down run. This is what Nebraska wants to get you in. Very close to second and four, and then they have you at their mercy.
See what they did that time again is they pulled the right guard and got him out there in the man that's assigned to take the quarterback and force him to pitch. Well, they can't force him to pitch. They block him, so he turns up inside and runs.
Well, we'll get a report from Jack Arute on the injured defensive lineman. That's Schuster powering to the 19-yard line, close to another first down, and Casey Hampton making the stop. Jack, how is the young man?
Here's the update. I just talked to the medical people here. They're going to take him in for x-rays. Gray Mosier is suffering from a shoulder problem as well as his ankle, Brent. And he also snapped his neck a little bit. So he has three very, very serious injuries in terms of being concerned. They're going to take him in and be safe about it and give him the x-rays.
Jack, thank you. It's third and one. The ball at the Horns 19, and this relentless march by the Huskers. Option look, late pitch, Evans, first down, out of bounds.
I think he should have just kept the ball going for the first down, but I'll tell you, again, that's one of those plays when they're blocking the man that takes the pitch. That's really tough. They call that a load option. I'll show you what I'm talking about right here. Here's the man that's going to take the quarterback. Well, they pull Zedeska right here and block him, so he's not in the quarterback's face. Now they have to get help from the secondary. See, he's right in that man's face. That gives him the cushion, plus he holds him. I think he should have gone and kept the ball and gone right up inside. Some quarterbacks, like Frazier, fake the pitch and go up inside.
Inches. The right foot out of bounds as he made the cut. Excellent replay showing him step out there. So it's fourth and one. Nebraska trailing it by 6 points. 23-17. The package comes in from Osborne's sideline. He had Frost over there to give him the play, and now they bring in Vershawn Jackson as an extra tight end. Frost, such a good runner, you would be so tempted to put him in right behind the middle of that offensive line. Dishman, Zadeska, Aaron Taylor, all those big fellas, and turn them loose. And they do just that. First down, Nebraska. Strong fella Scott Frost is. His mother, back in 1968, threw the discus for the United States Olympic team. His father, one-time running back at Nebraska, went out to Stanford. Bill Walsh used him not only as a quarterback, but also as a strong safety for a time. That's how good an athlete Scott is. Some question about his throwing ability, but he fits right in to this Nebraska offense. Faking, slips a tackle, and barges to the 16. So, his mother, who once also coached the track team back in Lincoln, and there is Scott Frost, who again won the state high school championship, Eric Anderson. Number 70 is right tackle, was second, and now we see that Chris Dishman is going off to that sideline.
Well, they might move Aaron Taylor over to left guard and move John Heskew center, backup center, up into that position.
Second and nine. That was a very positive defensive play for the Horns as they leave the Huskers here in second and nine. Fullback, not enough. Very close to the first down, Schuster, and he appears to be shaken up as he went down, slowly getting up to his feet. That quick hitter with Brian Schuster, who became a new daddy this week.
They love to run those quick traps in there. The guard will pull across from the left to right, kicks out, the tackle comes across right there, and there's that hole right up there. See, you start worrying about the option that they've been running outside you, the off-tackle play outside you, and all of a sudden they come up inside. And old Papa Schuster, wife just gave birth the other night to the baby boy. He's limping out.
D'Angelo Evans deep in this first end goal. Cross option look, pitch now to Evans. Evans tries to get the corner, dives toward the end zone, and got a touchdown. Nebraska, we're tied. So that is three touchdowns for the freshman from Wichita, Kansas, D'Angelo Evans, having a big day as he steps in to replace the injured Amon Green.
Cross did a real nice job of carrying that option out all the way. He held onto that ball and made the defender constrict the play slightly so he could pitch it and get it outside. Nice technique.
Now Malik. Chris Brown. So we've got timeout with Nebraska leading.
On the touchdown option play, Anderson and right here, and the tight end get a good job there. They had Hickerson right out there to make the play. See, the quarterback now, Frost, takes the ball to him, makes him stay there, and give the room outside for D'Angelo to get up the sideline.
Excellent effort. A couple of injured Nebraska players. Let's go down to Jack Arute, Jack.
Well, Brent, let's update you on Brian Schuster, the fullback. He took a helmet to the wall of the back. He is all right. Now, for Chris Dishman, the crew is working on him. He has an injured patella, and that's the kneecap. What they're going to do is they're going to fashion a rubber, what they call sleeve, put it over the kneecap to protect it. They think he'll be able to go back and play.
All right, Jack. Chris Brown kicking off. Nebraska with its first lead. It deep into the end zone. Mitchell will take a knee and it'll come out on the 20-yard line.
Critical now for Texas to come out and get the good drive, get it going. Don't lose confidence. Don't start to allow the momentum to swing the other way.
Got a shot at Dishman. Being fitted with that brace Jack was telling you about. 2:11 to go in the third, and James Brown, he's misfired only seven times. The interception, a huge one in the first half because it was in the end zone. Nebraska then came out and drove 80 yards for a touchdown the other way, and they were trailing 7-0 at the time. Now Brown brings the offense up to the line of scrimmage. Throwing on first down, and his tight end, Pat Fitzgerald, digs it out again.
See, and again, he ran that from a quick count. They just went up there and lined up. Offensive lineman and 2 points down, snapped the ball, and they allow Fitzgerald to go find that zone.
Officials timeout. They're going to huddle. Fitzgerald's numbers, impressive.
He's the record holder.
He also saved them prior to a field goal attempt when he prevented an interception by whacking a defensive back pretty good on a deflected ball. Let's not forget that play. The little things. First down and 10. You get the feeling that Texas is not done scoring. And I think Nebraska knows that too now. It's 24-23 Huskers. Here's the toss. Here's Williams looking for the left. Minter comes at him and rides him down. Penalty flag, however, as he was riding him out of bounds at the 37-yard line. The penalty flag came flying that time. And our referee from the Big 12, John Laurie, will sort it out.
Brent, that could be on the running back, because he might have gotten that stiff arm in the face.
Ricky could do that.
Yeah, that's, you don't do it on purpose, but it happens.
That is the first penalty against the Longhorns today. That's how well they have played here under Coach Makovic. Trailing for the first
holding
time.
Offense, 10-yard penalty, spotted foul. Repeat first down.
Here's the end of the play. Ricky Williams, number 11. See that right there in the face.
No question, he grabbed up around that face mask area with that hit. And with the hand up to the helmet area. And so Ricky, he's a very strong runner. He's probably not as fast as Mitchell overall, but he can beat you a little bit like Walter Payton used to do. Use that arm to help ward off would-be tacklers. 1:40 to go now. First and 20 for the Hornets. Brown. Far side.
Great coverage.
Outstanding coverage over there on McGarity, and at the freshman again. That's number 22, Ralph Brown.
Tight, tight man coverage. Now, Brown last week had the challenge of covering those gifted receivers at Colorado. See, he's not afraid to challenge that time because he knew he had safety help. You saw the safety working over to help him. So he goes ahead and works right up there aggressively. Set a new single game record last week for passes defended and knocked down with 7.
Second down and 20. Stadium sounds like Lincoln, Nebraska right now. Williams, and they had a hold of his shoe. Tomich was in on the play, and I believe it was Tomich who had a hand right on a foot and just held on.
Boy, did he get do a good job of getting off the ball on Pat Fitzgerald that time. You'll see Tomich come off the ball low and aggressively, 93 on Fitzgerald. Bang, he takes some pads down low, works upfield, reaches in there right there, and gets that back ankle. Excellent job by Jared Tomich.
You know, I think he pushed Fitzgerald into the leg.
He
as
did.
I saw that replay,
didn't
that
actually get a hand on it. Yeah.
Is what brought the running back down. Third down in 23. Brown under pressure. Tomich was coming, going deep, far side battle, and it's picked off. Warfield, Eric Warfield makes the interception for Nebraska.
He obviously didn't read the double zone coverage, Brent. They were pressing up tight there, double man. See the safety here to the right side of the screen. He's got this right half of the field. They play tight up in front, playing a pressure defense. Now the safety over here. He is right to the right side of your screen. Number 3 goes up there, Eric Warfield. He can high jump 6'8", and he demonstrated that right there. Should not have thrown that football.
Big series for the Texas defense. Trailing by a point, they were pounded by Nebraska's offense the last time. Frost makes the call, the big offensive line wearing him down. D'Angelo, the freshman, who certainly is no longer a freshman. He has grown up this season, and now he is Nebraska's leading I-back. Jackaroo, what about Coach Osborne here today?
Well, Brent, you know how normally Osborne, it's really hard to read. He doesn't get very emotional, doesn't get very excited. Well, during that last offensive series, when they scored the go-ahead touchdown, Tom Osborne was more excited than any of the players. He was jumping up and down, and he congratulated each of them as they came off the field.
Used the fullback, which is Makovica, who has replaced Schuster that time. And now he will go off short of the first down. One of the things that we will talk about when we come back is why Coach Osborne wants this championship more than any other. Well, Jackaroo touched on it. Why Tom Osborne wants this Big 12 championship so badly. When Texas and the Southwest Conference folded in with the Big 8, Nebraska lost a very important vote on non-predictors. And Osborne has harbored some bad feelings toward the Texas leadership in that vote ever since. And if Dr. Tom gets a chance here today, he will not call the dogs off. But it's been tough going. D'Angelo steps over to the left, and he is short but he did get a first down short of the 40-yard line. Let's find out about Army Navy. The classic's over. We send you to John Sonnen.
I think for sure Army will now go to a bowl game at 10-1. The Cadets, and they have earned it. First and 10 at Frost for Nebraska.
Back fires middle, almost intercepted. Should have been picked off by Tyson King.
He throws the ball with the nose down, Brent. There's no way you're going to throw the ball accurately that way. See, it started down right out of his hand. He's got to get the nose of that ball. I saw it coming. It was a play-action pass. There's Jackson 34 coming off, and the ball comes off his hand with the nose down. It's heading right into the linebacker. If he has the nose up, maybe that's the old shotgun technique, but he's got to get the nose up to get it over the top of those linebackers.
Let's see now. On second and 10, or puts it back in the air. Has a slot receiver over here to the right. And he's going to run Evans, and nothing doing that time. The Longhorns were all over on this. Chris Akins, number 96, the junior from Paris, Texas, gets in underneath and makes a nice defensive play.
Right side of your screen, Akins comes back underneath there, then jumps outside on Chris Dishman. He has been active in there all day long, playing hard, and I don't believe he's been substituted for at any time. He's played every snap.
This is third and 11.
Big play.
Big defensive stand so far for the Horns. Frost is going to put it up. Fire, got it, man. Hold on. First down, Nebraska at the 21-yard line.
That was a much better job, but the nose of the ball was still down a little bit. He's got to learn to get that up. He'll never throw the ball accurately if he doesn't get that thing up there. But that one was good for distance. Nice zone defense. Play action to freeze people. He'll play action fake to the left side of your screen. That holds the linebackers. See Dusty, number 46, step up. Then he throws it in that little zone, that curl zone. Right on the money. Nice job, Scott Frost.
Well, remember that play here in the fourth quarter. 22 yards on third and 11. Brendan Holbein goes at Nebraska, the receiver. And Scott Frost hands out to D'Angelo, cuts away, and he's tackled at the 18-yard line. That was King, number 50, making the stop again.
You know, they're running over there where they lost their starting defensive end, Gray Mosier, and now they're playing a true freshman over there most of the time, and they're running at him. I would, too. Boy, is he a good-looking freshman football player. He's no longer a freshman now. He's played enough football to be a veteran. But we saw him in his very first big one against Kansas State, and he had a heck of a game.
Second down and 7. Ball at the Horns' 18-yard line. Nebraska leads it by a point. Motion is started. This is Schuster. Alley cut back to the 12-yard line. And now you get the feeling that Osborne thinks he has worn down this defensive front, and he can pound away a little bit with the fullback on this drive.
Well, he told us yesterday that he thought they could pound on these people. They were a little more physical, bigger. He said they were a little bit inexperienced in that defensive front. But you really have to give Gary Garnell and the defensive staff Illinois credit, because these kids have really battled in there.
Yeah, the Texas youngsters have done well here. It's third and 2. Evans again inside the 10-yard line for another first down, Nebraska.
See, in those counter-type plays, those linemen run about 6-7 yards full speed, and at 300 pounds, when you get to the point of attack, it hurts. They make real good contact. Look at the size of Big Adam. Originally a walk-on at Nebraska. Worked his way to redshirt senior right out of Lincoln. Lincoln Pius X High School.
Schuster for a yard.
Same play they ran going the other way in the third quarter and popped him up inside there. This time they could not do it.
Jeff Lake is outside him. Second down and goal. Ball is on the Horns' 9. Here comes the blitz. Frost inside pitch on the ground.
Incomplete. Bounce once to Evans.
Oh, my gosh. That's just a forward pass situation right there. But I've seen them run that play before. They tried it earlier. They ran it last week, ineffectively. Get that end up field and then try to pitch it underneath them.
Here's the third down play. 9 yard line. Lance Brown splits wide out to the left. Double tight end. Schuster and Evans behind. Cross. Brown in motion. Ross gonna throw. Waits. Right side high and complete. Headed for a second, and then Lance dropped it with Vershawn Jackson coming through on that side. He was the receiver. Let me check that. That was not Lance. That was Vershawn Jackson in the back of the end zone. So let's check this replay on him.
Well, he's their receiving tight end. They like to throw him the football. Trey Johnson, 17, is chasing him all the way. The ball gets there in time, and he just gets his hand and pulls with his right hand on his right arm and gets the ball out of there. Good job by Trey.
Dick, on the far side, there was also a penalty flag thrown on the play. They're conferring with the
been penalized at all in the first half. That's your second one now in the second half, right?
Wow. Hard to play perfect football. They played awfully well.
You can expect them, in my opinion, Brent, here, that option series, though, they're showing spread with the calling time.
Timeout has been called by Nebraska, and it was pulled by a wide receiver. That was John Bedrill, who was going out to the slot, saw something he didn't like, so he called a timeout. We'll be right back. Well, the Texas defense has forced Nebraska to go the hard way. You can see what their average drive is here today at the time that is needed against this defense. And on this current drive, 11 plays for 50 yards, and here it comes now. Third down and goal from the 4-yard line, across the quarterback. Two tight ends. D'Angelo moves up behind him, and Frost changing up. Runs the option. Late pitch on the ground. How dangerous is that? Oh, baby.
I mean, he's already in field goal range. No sense in taking a chance. Now, he audibled the direction he wanted to throw the ball. He comes right down the line of scrimmage to Jackson down there. Guard pulls around, quick pressure, and he tries to flip it going down. He has not yet mastered the skills of running the option offense. Takes time. This is his first year at it.
Tyson hit him, and Chris Brown comes in. Remember, Nebraska leads it by one, 24-23. Federal. The holder. He'll check the outside rushman to see if they're going to come real hard off that far corner or the inside. And that puts them 4 points ahead with that field goal. So keep that in mind. A touchdown would have been a lot tougher mountain for Texas to climb than a 4-point deficit. We'll be right back. The Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship on ABC, brought to you by Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. Plymouth, one clever idea after another, that's Plymouth. And Wrangler, real, comfortable jeans. Brett Musburger with Dick Vermeil and Jack Arute. 10-11 left in regulation. Nebraska leading Texas 27-23. Brown kicks it off toward the end zone again. This one will come out of the 20-yard line. Well, Dick, what's your feeling now about James Brown and the Longhorns offense? What have you seen in this half?
Well, I've been impressed with him the entire game, but he's made the critical mistake twice in situations here. That time, there was no excuse to throw that forced ball down the sideline. He saw the pre-snap look of a two-deep safety. You know, and he's experienced enough to know what they're going to be doing there. Should not have thrown that ball. But I think he's got a lot of good throws in his arm right now.
The two interceptions, for all intents and purposes, represent the difference. And on first down, Brown, covered, slips away. He's beautiful on the move. Still going. Going to fire back. Dane got an open man. And it is his running back. Williams was free. He's down at the 37-yard line. That's making something out of nothing, Coach.
What a great impromptu play that. And he was also lucky he didn't get an offensive lineman moving downfield, because he was out there, looked like he was going to run, then he stops, and good pressure by the defense. And old Wisperum right here coming around from the backside.
Dick, he gets hurt on this play. He's going out. He's going out. He just took himself out with an arm injury. 9:48 left in regulation. No Wisperum. First and 10 coming from the 37-yard line. Mitchell was getting a handle on the ball, I believe.
Boy, there was real good defensive tackle play inside that time. They got penetration and just fouled up that entire play.
Big Jeff Ogard.
Big, and you mentioned Big. He's 6'6", 300 pounds. He's a man and a half.
Second down and 13. Priest Holmes exploded in the first half. Wisperum receiving medical attention on the sideline. It looks like they're reaching up onto that shoulder pad on the left shoulder. We'll get a report on that. So here is second and 13. Brown. Got it. McGarry in a foot race. Beat Stokes. He'll score. Wayne McGarry gives Texas a chance. 66 yards.
Now they'll kick it. Get the 3 point up there, and that time they ran that same double zone or double two safety secret, but they had a design pattern to go ahead and attack that kind of coverage. Slot receiver, right side of your screen, outside receiver controls that. Now he's on the safety minute, number 10, and he throws it in behind him. Here comes number 16, Eric Stokes, over there to get there. Good design pattern, good change up call.
A great move on Stokes, Coach, who was coming over. Dawson pounds in the extra point.
You know, he was a great running back in high school, and he demonstrated that right there, Brian.
30-27. Texas leads Nebraska again. Timeout.
You'll see McGarry right here. One-on-one on Minner. He goes down and takes him to the corner. There's a control route outside, and the safety can't get there to help him. Control route to give him the short route. Now that controls it. Beautiful throw right on the money. Here comes Eric Stokes, 16, to get over there. He gives him a little juke move up the sideline. He goes for the score.
That was some play when it goes.
Whoa.
Now, Wisdom, nice. The report, Dick, is it's a bruised left shoulder. It's recurring, and he's expected to be back in the game. 8:53 to go. The Longhorns are up 3 right now. That's the number we're on. It's 30-27. The last time, and that game was in Lincoln, when Nebraska beat him. I mean, how many of you people read articles this week that indicated, what's the reason for this game? Why show up? Wasn't the championship played between Colorado and Nebraska? How many of you saw those stars get close? There's a high hooch-type kickoff, Benning at the 21-yard line, coming back to the left, and field position at the 29-yard line. Dick, in a dome stadium, kind of surprised about kickoffs like that with a controlled environment and no wind.
Well, he's doing that because he's afraid of the long return, and he's kicking it to a designed area, kicking the ball high to get the hang time, okay. And defensing that one specific spot. Yes, maybe they'll get the ball more consistently 5 yards further, but they won't get the big one.
Scott Frost trailing again. Here's Evans to the short side, banged at the 31-yard line after gaining a couple of yards. Chris Akins.
Now, defensively that time, they showed him a normal defensive secondary right prior to the snap. They walked the free safety up, Chris Carter, number 16, and made it a 9-man front defense, and they happened to run right over where they had the extra people to slow the play down, and that allowed the defender to come from the backside and make the play. Good change-up call. Said, go ahead and throw. We want you to.
See what they come up with here on second and 8. They'll option it to the wide side of the field, and Frost is buried, coming out at the 34-yard line. This is going to be about 3rd and 5. Holding them to a 2-yard gain on first down is so important for a defense when you play Nebraska. It just absolutely changes the sequencing.
And that's exactly what Tom Osborne told us yesterday. We don't want to be in those long yardage situations. We want to come up second and three. We don't want those 7 and 8 situations.
But McAvick will take this to the other side of that.
You bet.
Well, let's make it third down and a long for the ball at the 34-yard line.
Went out the backside of the play action. He, you know, he gave us some tips before and it helped us.
Yeah, I wish we had him every week. He gives us everything.
I know.
It's out of Fullerton, Nebraska. Senior fullback Brian Schuster, and it is a first down for the Cornhuskers. Now 7:27 left. Schuster watching from the sideline, and freshman D'Angelo Evans, number 4. Wichita Flair. Still in there. Here he comes. D'Angelo. Short of midfield, but that's a gain of 4 to 5 yards. That's next. That'll be an aerial circus. BYU against Wyoming.
It will be entertaining. Remember the whack game we did? We went to Colorado State 2 years ago. What? It was a great, great weekend. Colorado State and Utah. And they scored some points.
Make it 2nd and 5. Cross. There's the pitch now to Sims, who checks in. Fresh running back to the 39. First down, Nebraska.
You know, they get you going and they get you coming. Wide receiver 6, Ken Cheatham, goes down and cracks block. The defender's working outside now, trying to get across the crack block, and the running back runs up inside. That option stuff can drive you crazy. Plus, you don't see it every week. You see it when you play Nebraska.
Cheatham, the wide receiver's out to the left-hand side of the formation. First down, and Sims again to the 40-yard line. One of the things you notice about Sims, as opposed to Evans, is that when Sims is hit the first time, he doesn't drive through that first would-be tackler the way that D'Angelo does, and D'Angelo now is checking back into the game.
Plus, he's not in the rhythm of the ball game. Think Eric Anderson, number 70, coming off, drive blocking there, the defender comes underneath him, and he just keeps working that big rear end of his upfield like that and opens up that outside hole.
300 pounds. 2nd and 6. Cross option, long pitch to Evans. They stretch it out, cuts away from the first tackler. Gains a couple of yards and no more. This is going to leave Nebraska now with a 3rd down and 4.
You used a great term to describe that, right? You said they stretched it out. That's what they're trying to do from a philosophical standpoint with that defense. Push the ball to the sideline. Now, Frost has been successful in that same play, turning back up inside that stretch. He couldn't do it that time. He had to pitch it. Good defense. The whole thing in the option game, they want to get you outnumbered in the perimeter and pitch it to their offensive people, and they have everybody else blocked, and there's no one to make the play. That's what they'd like to do.
Here's 3rd down and 4 yards. The ball at the Texas 38 for Nebraska.
Looks like they're lining up everybody.
D'Angelo didn't get it. It's 4th down, decision time for Osborne as Aaron Humphrey, the freshman from Lubbock, Texas, makes the hit.
See, they got good defensive charge. They had 9 people up close to the line of scrimmage. No place to go in there. People knocking other people down. The individual that ruined the play didn't make the play. He just ruined it.
The play is coming in from the sidelines. Brendan Holbein. They're going to go on 4th and 4. The one play that they always have liked through the ages in this situation is that option. But this time they're going to back cross up in the shotgun. But they can run it from here, remember.
Yeah,
they can option out of this.
And that formation spreads your perimeter all the way across the field, too. So it also gives you those lanes to run in upside, Brent.
But we got a timeout. Osborne took a timeout. That leaves the Huskers with 1. We'll be right back for 4th and 4. The sights and sounds of a wonderful Big 12 championship. And it was Wayne McGarrity who put them ahead for the fifth time today with this 66-yard scoring strike from James Brown. But now, with time running down here in the fourth quarter, fourth down and four. The ball on the 38, and Frost, the Nebraska quarterback, makes the call from the shotgun. D'Angelo Evans shifts to the other side of the formation. The numbers game. They're going to run it. There's a penalty flag, however, thrown by the referee.
They were trying to audible the direction of the
That's option. Against Nebraska.
And the defensive tackles lined up and then slid back. They called the audible and they slid the other way. Fouled them up. Good little adjustment by the defense that time.
Now there are 4 minutes and 14 seconds up on the clock. It now becomes fourth and nine. And the critical issue here becomes whether or not Jesse Cush punts it or Nebraska will fake it in this situation. 9 yards is a long ways to go. A good defense. They're at the 43-yard line. Carter, the safety, took his gloves off to field the free, or at least the fair catch. He's standing down inside the 10-yard line. Schuster, the up back, low snap. He does get it off. And a beautiful punt. Carter makes the catch at the 6-yard line, and he makes a mental mistake. So Nebraska survives a bad snap, and Cush does an outstanding job.
Now, that was the regular defense on the field. Carter is not their normal return guy. There's the bad snap. Great poise. He gets up there. I think he fielded that ball because he thought it might be down the inside that 5-yard line, Brent. That was an awfully good punt, but he's not their normal return guy.
Well, he has returned, but because of an injury, Coach, they took him out of that rotation.
Yeah.
That's why. But he has very good hands, but he does make a mental mistake, and the Longhorns are coming out from the six. And what a critical defensive series this is for Nebraska. Three-peat on the line and everything that goes with it. And penalty fly whistle before the snap.
Dead ball, false start. Offense.
Half the distance. It gets tougher and tougher. Jack, what's the latest on the young Mosier who was taken away?
Well, Brent, it's very, very, very good news for sophomore defensive end Gray Mosier. The results of the x-rays and the preliminary reads have all been negative. He's still complaining. There were a lot of soreness in his shoulder. I talked to both of his parents. They said they've spoken to him, and everything's good news. You won't see him back, but it's still good news for that youngster.
Second and 14. Motion by McGarrity. Brown slips. Rolls quickly to the right. Throws! What a catch! Did Fitzgerald have it? Yes, he did! Oh, brother! At the 12-yard line, a one-handed job.
What skill demonstrated by that young man. Under pressure in his own end zone, avoiding a safety, sprinting to his right, gets a nice block right there by Williams, lays it up there, pressure. What a nice catch. What a dangerous throw. Sometimes it works right.
8 yards. So that puts him in second and five. Remember, it was half the distance on the penalty. Now Priest Holmes, who explodes. First down. Warfield cannot write it down. Short of the first down, and that is a huge first down in this game.
That's the same play he broke for the long touchdown run, where you pull that backside guard, seal the defense off inside, and kick out with your fullback. It was effective that time for a first down, almost as important as that big long touchdown run.
Priest Holmes with 104 yards, two touchdowns, that 61-yard gain, 3:45. Makovic's horns bringing down the precious seconds on the clock. James Brown, is he going to be the master prognosticator? Hands it off now to Mitchell, who is jammed up at the 20-yard line. That's only about a yard before Jeff Ogard is able to wrestle it down.
Four of the Longhorns games have come down to the very last series of downs this year. They lost to Notre Dame in that very end series. They had a chance to beat Colorado on the last play of the ball game.
They are up 3 points. There's 3:12 to go. Remember that Nebraska has saved only one timeout. Makovic still has two, but John's desire now is to keep the clock moving. We've come to the 3 minute mark. Second down and 9 from the 20. Take Holmes. Now he throws it on out to the running back, Williams, and he's wrestled out by Warfield at the 25-yard line.
That's a nice action pass off the tackle trap that they were running early in the ball game, and they were getting pursuit down from the backside that stopped the play. That countered backside pursuit by slipping that fullback out there.
2 minutes and 48 seconds to go. This is 3rd and 4.
Now you're really in a quandary as a defensive coach. Do I risk the blitz and get that single coverage all around, or do I sit back and play my zone? Boy, it's a tough call.
Here's Holmes again to the 30, and if they spot it there, it's going to be a first down. It's going to be very close.
I think his knee went down earlier. Yeah, they moved the ball back.
Very close.
It is short, in my opinion, from here, Brent.
Now, Makovic is watching exactly where this ball is going to be spotted. Makovic wants to know, should he gamble right here and let Brown have a quarterback sneak? He's standing, he's watching the chains, because if he's got just an inch or so, why not? Wouldn't you, coach? It's dangerous. What would you do?
Inches right here with Nebraska on the field, I think I'd sneak it.
Me too.
It's easy to say that up here.
He agrees with you, coach. Yeah. He wanted to know what you thought.
Makovic is much more aggressive in his thinking in his entire career in these kind of situations than I ever was. And I mean that in respect to him. I've seen him do some things in situations where he's made assistant coaches mad. Hey, Nebraska and Notre Dame game, he had the lead and threw the passer. He got it intercepted and cost him the game at the end of the game, rather than just sitting on the ball.
Gotcha, here we go now. 4th and inches. No question what's about to happen. Fiebiger, number 58. On a roll, gonna throw it, got it wide open, baby! Derek Lewis in a foot race! And Jamel Williams has got him at the 10-yard line! What a call by Makovic!
What I tell you, you can't ever guess with him. Look at him. It's a nut. You have nothing to lose. You come in here, 21-point underdog, and you come up with a 4th and inches call. Hey, you deserve to win a football game when you have guts enough to call things like that. But it did not surprise me.
62 yards.
Good, strong action. Here's your tight end at the bottom of the screen. They're committing to stop that run. Here they are. I was thinking when I saw him reverse pivot like that, what are they doing handing the ball off that deep? Well,
and the young man, Derek Lewis, from New Orleans, does the rest. And now it is a 1st and 10 outside the 10-yard line. Here's Holmes, cutback, touchdown, Longhorns! They're celebrating on the Texas sideline.
What a great, great, great job of coaching. The best job we have seen done, Brent, in a long time.
The 3rd touchdown in the game for Priest Holmes. James Brown, come with me to Vegas, young man. You're the best prognosticator I've been around in a long time.
He just missed the point, that's all. But that was that same play that they ran for the touchdown, then in the critical situation a minute ago, they ran it for a 1st down. Now they come up for again a touchdown.
Dawson hammers it home. Other sideline, the sands of time running out now on the champion. Less than 2 minutes to go for Nebraska.
Is everybody up playing defense right here? And here he is, play action pass, no one covered him. I wouldn't have covered him either. I'd have stopped the run. Hey, they're not running, they're throwing. Big, big play.
Now, I'll tell you what the irony is there, ladies and gentlemen. Derek Lewis, who set up this touchdown run by Holmes, his 3rd of the day. Derek Lewis is from New Orleans. That's where Nebraska hoped to wind up to play Florida State. Now that story is all up in the air. There's the top 5. You make the call. Does Florida now get a rematch with Florida State if they handle Alabama? Or can Nebraska stage a miracle here in the last 1:53? And what will Ohio State do against Arizona State in the Rose Bowl? You think we don't have some stories that have unfolded late in college football? The big money on the line. And there's that high kickoff with three to keep it. Right up there, using Binning, sealing him at the 25. Not giving him a bust out, but he's still running. Going laterally. And number two makes a heck of a stop over there for the Longhorns. Let me tell you, that young man got the job done, and that's Tashi Allen, the corner on that side. So here are our Chevrolet most valuable players in this game. D'Angelo Evans, the Wichita Flash. And Priest Holmes. What a good story Holmes is. You folks down in Texas are aware he blew his knee out following the Sun Bowl. Missed all of that spring practice. And Chevrolet donates $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students. Cross fires Cheatham. High, got it, fumble. They'll call it incomplete. Ooh. I thought he had it.
He had it, but the safety got there. Chris Carter was supposed to be hurt and not play very much today. You know, he didn't practice with that ankle problem, but it's amazing how quickly you heal up when the emotion is added to the injury.
That's next. And a tradition begins here in St. Louis. They'll be talking about the Big 12 going into next season, you better believe. Second down now. They make that direct run by D'Angelo Evans. He was the ball carrier that time. Jackaroot. Time is running out here on Nebraska.
Yeah,
looks like we're
going
to have a new national champion, partner.
But remember one thing. Remember when we talked to John Makovic? One of the key elements he said was motivation. And he said to his guys and he said to us, hey, there may be a kid in a wheelchair that sees us and is inspired by our performance. Looks like he was a prophet about that.
He sure was, Jack. And as Dick has pointed out, this is a heck of a job by the players and the coaches.
That offensive line just did a miraculous job in scheming and preventing the pass rush, the pressure. They were able to both run and throw the football. Nobody has been able to do that to Nebraska all year other than Arizona State.
Well, you wonder now what this does to someone like BYU, Colorado, Tennessee. Their chances for the Alliance, you would think that Colorado probably would fall out. Nebraska certainly would stay in it. There's a completion, although this figures to be their second loss. Holbein giving Nebraska a first down. Still a minute to go, trailing by 10. They're in a hurry up.
Well, they don't have a lot of practice at this phase of their offense, Brent. Coming from behind at the end.
Frost, the time, intercepted King. This one's over, ladies and gentlemen. There's a penalty flag. Hold on.
Yeah, there was defensive offsides, so that's going to go back to Nebraska. They'll give him the ball. Unless the offensive player moved.
I believe it's against Texas, Coach. Yeah.
Offside. Yeah. On the defense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
The call of the year against that man. John Makovic's fourth and inches call after standing over there with James Brown. Who knows? There are probably some general managers and owners in the NFL that said, can I get John Makovic's phone number?
Well,
and
he's been there before. Yeah. He's one of the few coaches that got fired with a winning record. I think they won 10 games his last year there. No, he's an excellent football coach.
Left side, the angel will step out of bounds. That is the first down. Stops the clock. 46 seconds. Well, this really throws the bowl picture up in the air. And Texas automatically will go into the Alliance with a win here. But they do not automatically receive the invitation to play as expected Florida State in the Sugar Bowl. It is still to be determined. Out of bounds, almost complete at the 22-yard line, and Nebraska still firing away right now, trying to get something to do. That was Shevin Wiggins. That was his first reception of the game. 41 seconds, and the champion going down blazing here one way or the other. They certainly haven't given up on it.
They want to stick it in the end zone and go to the onside kick as quickly as they can. Frost. Fumble.
There it is. Texas has done it. They have won the inaugural Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. They have upset three touchdown favorite Nebraska.
Well, John said that they like to roll the underdog, and they were going to play on that. He told the squad, I want you to inspire every underdog in America that's watching this game.
There's the young man who created the storm throughout the Midwest and Texas when he said, no, I will win by three touchdowns. Off by a few points, Jay, but very, very good call. And another good one coming your way.
Yeah, you bet.
Goes in the way.
Don't turn your set off.
It ain't bragging if you back it up, right, Jay?
That's good.
Just take a knee now, and it'll run out. We'll have a new champion this year, and still no team in the history of college football has been able to three-peat. John Makovic with the play call of the year. Tom Osborne.
He will handle it with class. He's got a lot of that.
They'll shake hands now at the 25-yard line. The Texas Longhorns have won the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. A 10-point victory by the underdogs as the Horns have done it. Let's go down to Jackaroo, Jack.
Coach, the obvious thing, a disappointment. What do you think the key was to the loss?
Well, I don't know. We didn't seem to play with quite the intensity we have, but Texas played very well. We just got to give them a lot of credit. And they that was a great call they made on fourth down and 6 inches. You know, that was kind of the ball game right there. And so I admire their tenacity. They went after it. We just didn't make the plays when we needed to.
You have always said that what was important is how well the game was played. How do you rank this one?
Well, I think we did some good things, and yet probably defensively it didn't play quite like we have been. But that's partly Texas's offense played very well.
Thank you, Coach.
Hook 'em horns. Makovic, and Texas does it. Let's go back to Jack.
Well, Coach, what do you think of James Brown and his predictions now?
Well, it's not three touchdowns, but we'll take it. What a football game. I cannot say enough about what our coaches did to get the team ready, but these players gave it, and it is something that we'll never forget. The first Big 12 championship ever, that was one of our team goals. we're going to celebrate tonight.
Don't want to hold you. Go ahead. Thanks, Coach.
Coming into this game, the headline was, will the Huskers play taps on the horns? Not today. Texas wins it, and the WAC championship is coming up next. So long, everybody. Where